We have three voices from the BJP tonight. We have GVL Narasimha Rao and Sambit Patra. In Delhi, we have Jyoti Kiran Shukla in Jaipur. So that let the BJP defend itself as strongly as it can. We have three non-BJP voices tonight, so it's totally balanced. We have Kavita Krishna, National Secretary of the All India Progressive Women's Association. We have Vrinda Grover, human rights lawyer and well-known activist. And we have Ami Agnik of the Congress Party. Simple question to start with before we go into details of this. I think the most abominable comment of the day today, Mr. Rao and Sambit Patra will agree, is coming from the BJP National Vice President, Mr. Prabhat Jha, who says Sangeen Aaropi Hai Nahi. But if, how is the allegation of rape and sexual exploitation of a young woman who is being used allegedly as a pawn by her own husband, right, for his own political and business deals, this is not a Sangeen Aarop? This is not a serious charge? What is a serious charge, Mr. Rao, Mr. Patra? Is this what you told the people of this country when you were running the campaign? Suddenly after you are in power, allegations of rape don't become a serious charge? When your central minister is summoned by a judicial court on the basis of a revision letter which points out serious flaws in the Rajasthan police's report on the basis of which this case was dismissed in the first place? This is not a serious charge? So the minister is right because he's a minister, Mr. Patra, Mr. Rao, and the woman is wrong because she's not a minister. What kind of logic is this? Why are you doing this? No, why are you doing this? What kind of defense mechanism have you adopted tonight in this case? And do you think people are not watching you? They are not judging you, and they are not saying tonight that you need to walk the talk?
Arnab, it's important to go one into the facts of the case.
Yeah, I'm going into the facts of the case.
It would not be proper to... Yeah, please, let us present the facts. I think let the people judge. I think, you see, the whole thing...
What is the fact of the case? A young woman says that this man was one among 17 people who raped me in connivance with my own husband.
No, no, the police... Come on, the police investigated the case. The police investigated under orders of the High Court. They continued investigation orders of the High Court. And the police found the orders were, the police investigation showed that the charges were untrue.
That police investigation is under a cloud, sir. That police investigation is under a cloud. Vrinda Grover shaking her head, completely disagreeing with you. That police investigation is under a cloud.
No, it is not.
Sir, what do you mean it is not? It is.
Repeatedly different courts.
It is, otherwise this minister would not have got a notice. This minister has got a notice because the police investigation is under a cloud.
That's not correct.
Arnab,
At least check your facts, Mr. Patra.
That this is a very sensitive case and we have to hold it very sensitive. Let's not have a combat. Let's not have a combat.
Mr. Patra, he may be the lone representative from Rajasthan on the Council of Ministers, but the fact is he has been issued a notice by a Jaipur court in connection with an alleged rape case on June 12th.
Yes, Arnab, and that is why I say, since looking into the sensitivity of the case, let us
don't keep repeating the line sensitivity. Come to the facts.
Let us have a serious discussion. Let us have a discussion on this. First and foremost, I would like to very humbly begin by saying that putting together all the respected panelists, including Arnab, you, our wisdom will be belittled to the judicial wisdom that the country holds.
Oh, please.
And this particular case has passed through, if I remember, through three judges, through three courts. What is right or what is wrong, only time will tell. But I have faith in India's judiciary. If I see that a metropolitan magistrate and a district magistrate has gone through this particular case for one long year, not for one day, one month or 2 months, but for one long year, there must be some merit in deciding this case. And in fact, one of the 16 men...
First of all, don't look at things selectively, Mr. Patra. And by the way, don't keep repeating the line.
No,
sensitive,
I'm not
sensitive.
Looking...
What is sensitive, Mr. Patra?
No,
please allow me to complete,
line.
Mr. Patra. You may take your party line, but the fact of the matter is this. The fact of the matter is this, please, Mr. Patra. The Metropolitan Magistrate Rajendra Singh Yadav accepted the police report on the February 10th, 2014. This forced the victim to file a review petition before the additional district judge, who, after hearing the victim, right? You are a doctor, but sometimes I hope at least you also have the sensitivity and the understanding of a lawyer. Now, if you were a lawyer, you would have understood this, Mr. Patra. Please, 1 second, please, Mr. Patra.
Mr.
Patra, allow me to complete. Allow me to complete. After hearing the victim,
please.
After examining evidences, Brinda Grover, am I right that the notice was issued asking the accused?
The summons were issued on the request of one of the accused. I want to get Brinda Grover and the others, please, with your permission.
Kavita Krishna, Ami Agnik, I want to get Brinda Grover in first on the case.
Yes, one of the accused went to the High Court and the High Court,
gentlemen,
Justice K.C. Ahluwalia categorically
said, gentlemen, please calm down.
The revision petition is
gentlemen, what I am saying here is that there is a note.
Should be heard. Remember, the High Court has already speculated.
Yeah, 1 second.
Arnab,
Mr. Sambit Patra, I'm letting Brinda Grover in because I don't think you're going to give way otherwise. Brinda Grover. Brinda Grover, 1 second. And by the way, Sambit Patra and GLK, Mr. Rao, I'll just give you a little bit of food for thought in the meantime, please. Something for you to chew on and think about. I remember that on 26th February, and you have, I think, smartphones with you, go and Google search. On the 26th of February, 2014, the Bharatiya Janata Party took a principled position and said in the course of its election campaign, there can be no compromise when it is a case in which there is a grave allegation against a woman. And your party, Mr. Patra, your party, Mr. Rao, your party, Ms. Jyotish Kiran Shukla, demanded the immediate resignation of Uttarakhand Minister Harak Singh Rawat from the cabinet on moral grounds a day after the Delhi police booked him on charges of molesting a woman. Forgotten? Forgot that?
No,
I am bringing it back to you. Brinda Grover is coming into the debate.
Brinda Grover coming to the debate.
I'm only putting some facts in. Even if the facts make you uncomfortable, do not respond.
Arnab, eight of the accused could not
told by the BJP.
They don't even exist. And Nihal Chand, we don't even know whether it is Miss this Nihal Chand. There is complete confusion about the accused in this case.
Please.
The police investigated
counsel?
And said eight
are
of the 19 accused.
For Mr. Nihal Chand
eight
you
of the 19
the
accused don't exist.
Are these BJP spokesperson masquerading
eight of the 19
as the defense
don't
counsel
even
of
exist.
Nihal Chand? I see. So now we were told we should respect the wisdom of the
there
judiciary
no,
and the
there are
BJP
no details given. So this case
can
is
we,
very peculiar.
Can somebody
please don't go. Please go into the facts
oh, really?
Carefully
let her speak.
Before you the, damning before you damn
can
individual.
We can somebody else put in a word?
So the courts
let her speak.
After the BJP spokesperson Mr. Patra begins by saying let's not be combative, they refuse to allow anybody to come in, and slowly but surely they are now going to attack the veracity of the complaint. They are masquerading as defense counsels for this accused minister.
That's what
minister.
The police have said.
Nobody on this panel,
that's
what, at
that's
least I am not.
The police
can I please finish? I did not interrupt you. Kindly learn to listen to the
speak.
People of this country.
Yeah, you have to state the facts. You cannot imagine that. You cannot present imagine.
Her facts don't have to agree with yours and what she says. If it disagrees with you, they don't become.
Those in political power will
speak on the basis of facts.
No, 1 second. I must say this. No, listen to her. What she says, she does not have to say what you say is right. And just because what she says is not what the BJP wants to hear, does that mean that it is a falsehood? Just like what you're saying, what the victim says is a lie.
No, it has to be based on facts.
What is fact? Your facts are facts and everybody else's point of view is fiction.
You cannot imaginary, you cannot present imaginary facts.
Allow them to complete. They have a right to argue with you.
A court of law.
Sambit Patra, allow her to complete.
This is what happens when you come to power.
No, I heard her and thereafter.
No, you are not hearing her. She heard you.
Yes, I'm sorry, Mr. Patra. You are not allowing me to complete a single argument.
Please complete and then allow me to answer as well, ma'am.
The matter is pending before a court of law. It is still being looked into by a court of law. All that is being said today is not convict him, hang him, imprison him. At least I am not saying that. What is being said here is this person who has an allegation of rape, sexual assault, sexual exploitation. His name was in the FIR in 2011. when he was inducted into the cabinet, this fact must have been known to the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, or at least you all should have brought it to his knowledge. Is this man fit to be a Minister of State and be in the cabinet? What is the signal going out at a time when there is systematic and rampant sexual violence against women? Now the BJP, as the SP has been doing this all these days, is saying women's rights do not matter.
Come on, why are you glossing over the fact
as election that the trial court has already secondly,
has found no merit in these allegations?
I give a 30 seconds to complete. Let her complete, Sambit Patra.
Secondly, a person, a cabinet minister, chasing a cabinet minister when misuse his position to overawe the victim, to not allow the case
an argument being put.
Intimidate witnesses.
An argument being put. One second, Jyoti Kiran Shukla is our next speaker. She's coming in from Jaipur. She raises her hand out there. Jyoti Kiran Shukla is spokesperson of the Rajasthan BJP. Is it true or not, Jyoti Kiran Shukla, that there are some serious flaws that have been questioned in the Rajasthan police's report? And one of those things which is now being alleged is that the Rajasthan police report allegedly omitted information about the main accused, which is the husband in this case. Is it true or not that as per the allegation, the Rajasthan police asked the victim for a witness in a case of gang rape? Do you ask a victim for a witness in a case of gang rape? Do you go and ask a rape victim produce a witness in this case? What can be worse than this, Ms. Shukla? You build a case, your Rajasthan police asks, no, 1 minute. And a woman who is allegedly exploited is told, go bring a victim. Go bring a victim, a witness to your gang rape? And if you can't produce a witness to your gang rape, your case does not hold? Who should be pulled up today?
Arnab.
Arnab,
this is a text. This is a textbook case of political conspiracy. Take my words for that. There is another angle to that. I think we should present that
now
angle
we will
also.
Take her verdict
and Rao. Brinda, please allow me to answer. I never interrupted when you were speaking. See, Arnab, you should look at the natures of the FIRs that the complainant has given. She has appeared before the NHRC. There was no name of any 19 accused. She has appeared. Her statements have been recorded under the 164. Please, Arnab.
Is it wrong to appear before the NHRC?
19, no, not at all. But it is absolutely under her rights to appear wherever she wants. But at the same time, she should give the correct versions. Three versions, three courts, three police investigations, three statements under 164.
Why don't you look at it this way, that now, the woman is constantly continuing to fight for justice? The Rajasthan police, in fact, asked the victim, tell me the particular date.
No, what's it?
What is the conspiracy?
Why don't you look at the other? Arnab, why don't you look at the angle of the political conspiracy also? Why in the
isn't the conspiracy angle an easier one to throw back at the victim?
Allow me to complete at least the sentence.
Okay, after you complete, I'll go to complete. You have a right to have your point of view.
2011. In 2011, in the FIR which the complainant has given, there is no name. Only the gender harassment and dowry case was there, and only the family members were accused. After that, the jurisdiction has changed, and a fresh case, a fresh FIR in Vaishali Nagar.
She says in her interview that I am being harassed, I am being pressurized. Maybe she is running from one place to the other. It's not easy for a victim to fight the system. Is it easy for a victim to fight the system?
Not at all. For your record, there are three types of versions running in three media channels.
No, forget the versions of the media channels. Where is the inconsistency in what the woman? The woman is saying, I was gang raped. My husband.
Arnab, victims' versions I'm talking about in last 3 days. I'm sure you're tracking Nihar.
No, I am tracking the versions of the victims also. One second. In this case, please remember one thing. The Rajasthan police asks the victim for a particular date of rape. When this happened over a period of time. Let's argue logically. Second, the Rajasthan police says, give me a witness in the case of gang rape. Third, the Rajasthan police allegedly omits information about the main accused, which is the husband in this case. Fourth, the Rajasthan police is also accused of not pursuing the main accused for a CD he made of the victim's rapes, right? Fifth, And please, let's argue very logically tonight. The Rajasthan police allegedly did not check the places of crime and did not present the accused before the victim. You don't check the places of the crime. You don't. No, no, 1 minute. No, 1 minute, please. Sambit Patra, let's argue coldly tonight and not through the prism of political bias, Mr. Sambit Patra. The Rajasthan police did not check the places of the crime. The Rajasthan police could not have checked the present the accused before the victim. The Rajasthan police asked the victim for a witness to the crime. The Rajasthan police asked the...
Supposedly, you want to help the victim or make it difficult for the victim.
Why are you presenting the facts selectively? Are you accusing the judges of impropriety?
Are you trying to say that the judges did not see all this?
Of course, somebody has seen all this. Somebody has seen all this, which is why the case is being opened and notices are being given.
Going to all these facts?
Kavita Krishnan.
No. You are missing out the High Court Connect also. The High Court Connect is missed over here. Justice KC Ahluwalia, in this particular case, told that before the review commission comes up for hearing, all the 17 people have to be heard. So they have to be heard now before the review petition is open.
Absolutely.
So why are you accusing the woman of lying?
Absolutely.
I have one question. Why do you accuse the woman of lying? All three of you are accusing the woman of lying or making up the facts or being part of a political conspiracy.
No one is accusing her. We are only going through the court.
You are saying conspiracy.
Absolutely.
You are saying conspiracy.
See, what?
No, no, 1 second. No, Jyoti Kiran Shukla is saying conspiracy. You are saying that this woman is not a victim.
Because
you are saying this woman is part of a political plot. That's what you're saying.
Arnab.
You're saying she's part of a political plot.
Wait a minute, Arnab. The FR that was done was under the Congress regime. You're saying a woman is lying about being raped by this man.
That's your basic argument. You're saying this 24-year-old woman is lying about being raped by this man. The man is right. The woman is wrong. How predictable is that argument, Miss Jyoti Kiran Shukla? You just say a woman is part of a political conspiracy. That's what you say tonight. That everybody.
Don't put words in my mouth.
You just said conspiracy, didn't you?
Allow me to. No, I said.
You said conspiracy.
But I never said.
You said conspiracy by whom?
You are,
so
you
she's a pawn in a political conspiracy.
Basically, you are questioning the wisdom of three courts also.
No, I'm not questioning. I'm saying that you are saying the woman is part of a conspiracy.
No,
whose conspiracy? You tell me whose conspiracy?
I said it appears.
No, whose conspiracy? Why don't you elaborate? Whose conspiracy?
I said it appears.
Who's conspiring?
I said it appears.
Whose conspiracy?
I think it appears because
whose conspiracy?
Here,
political conspiracy. Whose conspiracy? Whose conspiracy, ma'am? Please be specific. Don't put an allegation and try to get away. Whose conspiracy are we talking about?
I'm not putting an allegation.
Who's conspiring against the minister? Who's conspiring?
See, it
who's conspiring?
See, basically Congress.
So the Congress is conspiring by using her. So she's being used by the Congress party. Ami Agnik will respond to that. Ami Agnik first of the Congress party has to defend that, and after that I'm going to go to Kavita Krishna. I apologize for the delay and going to Mr. Krishna. Ms. Krishna, 20 minutes into the debate, but let her respond first. Yes, please. And by the way, Ms. Kavita, Ms. Ami Agnik, let me begin by saying that I find it very fascinating here that your party's response when your minister in Uttarakhand was accused of molestation and this particular case are absolutely similar. You are competing head to head. You are in fact in a race with the BJP in defending. Your minister was accused of molestation. This one figures in a rape case. Both were allowed to continue by their parties.
The Congress, they are clear winners. Don't say that.
Well, it's unfortunate that we are coming down to this, isn't it? But isn't it? Did the Congress not defend Harak Singh Rawat? Is he not agriculture minister in the Uttarakhand government? Did Harak Singh Rawat not take questions from the media? Did he not run away from the Times Now cameras exactly in the way that Nihal Chand is running away from the questions? So Mr. Ami Agnik,
Nihal Chand said he is available for any discussion.
Really, he is. All I've seen him run away from our reporters.
He sees a camera and he sees a ghost.
He runs away in the opposite direction.
Can I answer, please?
Yes, Ami Agnik. She's accused you of a Congress conspiracy in this.
Arnav.
Yeah.
Today on your channel, the victim has said that she is running from one place to another because she wants to be safe. She has accessed the police system and the legal system, but she has not been able to access the justice system. But what has the Rajasthan government or the center given any protection to her? That is the first and foremost issue that comes to the fore. Have they immediately given any police protection to her for her safety? That is one thing. The second thing is, it's not time for comparisons or competing. Here is a minister who is one of the accused of the 17 accused.
Ask question to your own chief minister.
I think please let me complete.
Now again, Mr. Patra, you are interrupting.
Mr. Patra, you tell the BJP spokesperson to keep quiet for a while.
Why no?
The BJP spokesperson has made it a habit to speak continuously so that no one else can speak.
That is not the question of. You should ask this question. You should have asked this question from Ashok Gehlot.
I am giving the bare fact. Today the victim is without any protection. And you have talked only of women's safety by campaigning, and this is your double speak that is coming to the front. What about the women's safety?
No, we are coming. Because you campaigned on that.
You came to power for that. You please let me complete. I am not arguing with you. Please let me put my case.
No, but you can't.
You have campaigned on the ground that we will give women safety, and you are not able to give safety and protection to one victim.
We are committed to that.
So where is the protection? First you give the victim protection so that she can access justice. And where is the BJP party who said that we want a stronger India, we want protection to women? Don't compare with the Congress. There is no conspiracy. There is a woman who has filed a case against 17 accused. We are not arguing one-to-one case, madam. Please have the patience to listen to some other panelists.
You are arguing
one-to-one. This is not a one-to-one case. No.
No, madam, you are arguing one-to-one.
No, you have to think about the victim. There is a women's safety issue.
So did you think about the victim? One second. Ami Yagnik, one of the delightful opportunities of being voted out of power is that you can completely do a U-turn on the positions you took when you were in power. Now, I know you are out of power in nationally, but you are still in power in Uttarakhand. So, in Uttarakhand, when Harak Singh Rawat, a minister, agriculture minister, was booked by the Delhi police for allegedly molesting a woman last year, when the woman filed a written complaint, 1 minute, saying Rawat misbehaved with me, saying, and I'm sorry to have to go into detail, that at many points of time, he was touching me inappropriately. I want you to tell the entire country they're watching you tonight. As the vanguard of women's rights run by a woman, a party whose president is a woman, whose rising leader Priyanka Gandhi is a woman. Right, 1 minute. 1 minute. A party which says we are for women's empowerment. Tell me, what did you do? What did you do in that case?
We are not talking about all
of you. But I want to know whether you have the right high moral ground.
Why are you bringing the talking about women's safety?
I want to know whether you have the high moral ground to talk about the subject.
Where is the party that has come to power talking about women's safety?